adherence is dynamic. It changes over time. And that is why we want to get people on LAIs, because they may be adherent for periods of time, but perhaps not on an ongoing basis. And to be honest, that's the norm for all chronic illnesses. People with hypertension, people with diabetes, everyone who has to take chronic oral therapy goes through this same struggle. It's just the nature of the game with chronic conditions. But unlike diabetes, if I get back on my metformin, my A1C will go back down. What happens is once I become non-adherent and relapse, I lose brain function, and that may not be recoverable. And so our perspective now on schizophrenia and relapse is that relapse is not inevitable. Relapse is preventable, and relapse is unacceptable. And it's for this reason in particular. And this is why we want to offer everybody an LAI, and we want to offer it as soon as possible, early on in the course of treatment. This data comes from a large clinic in Toronto, which is academically affiliated. Episode one are people who got put on an oral agent and respond, and you see the reduction in their symptoms. So going down is a good thing, okay? They're having improvement in their positive symptoms. On the y-axis, they use the BPRS. Academically affiliated clinic, they did BPRS on these people. That group was then non-adherent with their oral therapy. So they came back, and they put them back on the same drug. Second time around, they don't respond as well. That's after one relapse. And if you have multiple relapses, well, guess what happens? You wonder why you have to give people so much D2 blockade. Sometimes they need it from day one, but sometimes it's because what has happened to their brain with successive relapses. And this is why our whole perspective on using LAIs has completely flipped. So I'm much older than Amber. When I trained in the last century, actually it was the last millennium, that's how old I am. It was a fail first model for LAIs. You had to earn your right by being non-adherent. We now realize that's completely backwards. Everyone should be entitled to and offered an LAI from day one, because once you lose your brain function, it ain't coming back. And yes, we're not happy when people are rehospitalized. Patients are not happy when they have exacerbations. I work in a forensic system. Big reason people end up there is because of non-adherence, but it's number one right there. I can get somebody out of jail. I can help them be restored to competency to face their charges. Maybe we can get their housing back. I can't grow their brain back, though. And that is really why we want to get people on LAIs from day one.